Hello students, how are you? Today we are going to take up the inspirational chapter Deep Water by the eminent American writer William Douglas. In this chapter, William Douglas talks about fear and his victory over fear. Let us talk about William Douglas. Douglas was born in the year 1898 and he died in the year 1980. He was born in the state of Minnesota. After graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in English and Economics, he spent 2 years teaching at a high school in Yakima. Now, Yakima is the name of a town in the USA and it is also name of an American river. Douglas served as a jurist and a politician. His term as a justice of the Supreme Court was the longest ever. There is one more thing which you have to remember about Douglas, that he was a good friend of the famous American president, in fact, one of the greatest American presidents, FDR, Franklin D. Roosevelt. These are his initials. In this inspiring chapter from his autobiography of Men and Mountains, Douglas talks about his fear of water and how he finally overcame it. So this chapter is about fear of water, which is also called hydrophobia. Now this is photograph of William Douglas and this is his tombstone. There are two incidents which created fear in the mind of William Douglas. The first incident happened when Douglas was a little child, aged 3 or 4 years, and this incident is known as the California Surf Incident. The word surf, it can have two meanings. It is related to surfing, a water activity, and it is also related to sea waves. When the author was 3 or 4 years old, he went for surfing with his father to the beach in California. A big wave knocked him down and swept over him. He got scared. This incident created an aversion to water in Douglas. The word aversion, it simply means dislike. So Douglas developed a dislike to water after the California surf incident. The second incident, which is more important because the first one, California surf incident, it covers only a paragraph in the chapter, whereas the second incident, YMCA swimming pool incident, it covers about 2 pages. The YMCA swimming pool incident, YMCA. It is an acronym for a famous charitable organization, Young Men's Christian Association. YMCA swimming pool incident took place when Douglas was 10 or 11 years old. Remember, California surf incident at the age of 3 or 4 years, YMCA incident at the age of 10 or 11 years old. At that age, William Douglas went to the YMCA swimming pool to learn swimming. He had two alternatives, either to learn swimming by going to Yakima River or to learn swimming by going to the YMCA pool. So he opted for the YMCA pool and he rejected the alternative of Yakima River. Now you might be asked in exam, why Douglas did not go to the Yakima River and why did he select the YMCA pool? Douglas did not go to the Yakima River to learn swimming because the Yakima River is treacherous. What's the meaning of the word treacherous? It is risky. It is dangerous. Many people had drowned in it. The YMCA pool was safer as the fall was gradual from shallow to the deep end. YMCA pool was safer because its slope was gradual. It was not steep. Now, when he went to the YMCA pool, Something happened. A big muscular boy. He came to the YMCA pool when nobody was there except Douglas. Douglas was all alone. And this boy, who is referred to as the big bruiser of a boy. The word bruiser is somebody who is muscular and somebody who has the build of a boxer. Now this boy, this big bruiser of a boy, he threw Douglas into the deep end of the pool and he cried, "Hi skinny, how do you like to be ducked?" Douglas started drowning as he did not know how to swim. But William Douglas, he was made of a strong stuff. He was a boy with a rational mind. When he was going down, he did not panic initially. He retained control over his mind and he made a plan. He made a strategy. In exam, this question is frequently asked, that what was the plan or strategy made by Douglas while he was drowning in the YMCA pool? And what was the plan? When his feet hit the bottom of the pool, he would make a big jump, come to the surface like a cork, lie flat on the surface of the swimming pool and paddle to the edge of the pool, and then he would be out of water. Now what do you think? Will the plan succeed? Is it possible that somebody who has no idea about swimming can implement such a plan? Obviously, the plan failed. Douglas tried three times and each time he failed. He tried to push the bottom and make a big jump to come to the surface and paddle out. He failed all the three times. He reached the surface, but not as quickly as he thought he would do. He used his hands and feet to come to the surface, but failed. He saw yellowish water all around. He flailed his arms and legs. Flailed, this means to throw arms and legs aimlessly. He cried for help. He screamed for help. His lungs ached. His head throbbed. He turned dizzy. He felt paralyzed. Now all these, the things which I am underlining, you can use when you are writing long answered questions. Terror seized him. He tried to jump three times and each time he failed to come out of the swimming pool. Finally, he lost consciousness and it was as if the curtain of life fell. There is this line in the chapter, "I crossed to oblivion and the curtain of life fell." Oblivion is a state of forgetfulness. When somebody crosses to oblivion, it means somebody has turned unconscious. When his eyes opened, Douglas found himself lying on his stomach near the pool. He was vomiting. The big bruiser of a boy who had thrown him in the YMCA pool, he merely said to the people who had rescued William Douglas, "But I was just fooling. It was only a joke." Now the YMCA incident left deep marks in the mind of William Douglas. There were two types of effects. One, short-term effects, and then long-term effects. In exam, you might be asked about both the effects or one of the effects. The YMCA swimming pool incident left Douglas weak and trembling. He cried, wasn't able to eat for some days, and he felt wobbly. He felt shaky. So all these were short-term effects. Now the long-term impact, the real impact, was that Douglas wasn't able to go anywhere near water. He developed a fear of water. He developed hydrophobia. Now this was the long-term impact, long-term effect. And because of this long-term impact, William Douglas was not able to enjoy water sports. For many years, Douglas wasn't able to go near water and enjoy water sports or water activities. Whenever he went near water, his legs would become paralyzed an icy horror would grab his heart. The fear of water, which he calls his handicap. In this chapter, William Douglas uses the word handicap for his fear of water. It spoiled his fishing trips. He wasn't able to enjoy other water activities like canoeing, boating, swimming. So he decided that he wanted to enjoy life. He wanted to enjoy water activities. To remove his fear of water, Douglas decided to hire an instructor to learn swimming. It took the swimming instructor about 6 months to remove fear of water, which had haunted Douglas for many years. In the chapter, you will find instructor started training Douglas in the month of October, and this training it continued till the month of April. So 6 months. Now, what did the instructor do to remove fear of water from Douglas's mind? The instructor used three steps. These are very important. You have to remember keywords. The first step, the instructor attached a rope to a belt which was worn by Douglas. The rope went through a pulley on an overhead cable. One end of the rope was tied to the belt worn by Douglas, and the other end of the rope was held by the instructor. Each day, Douglas was asked to go back and forth across the pool for many hours. This process was repeated for 3 months. Slowly, Douglas became comfortable as his tension began to slack. He relaxed. Okay, students, don't laugh at this drawing. It is created by me and it is quite obvious. This is the best I can do. Now, this is William Douglas. And this is his swimming instructor. Now, William, in the first step, a belt was tied around William Douglas. A rope was tied to this belt, and this rope went over a pulley. The other end of the rope was held by swimming instructor who was standing at the other end of the swimming pool. Now, William Douglas was asked to go back and forth in the swimming pool, and this process was continued for many hours, several days, in fact 3 months. And during this process, what happened? His tension began to slack. Douglas became relaxed. Now let's move to the second step. The second step, Douglas was taught to put his face under water and exhale, and to raise his nose and inhale, a kind of breathing exercise. This exercise was repeated for many weeks. Bit by bit, Douglas shed his panic that seized him when his head went underwater. So second step, remember exhale and inhale. Third step, the instructor held Douglas at the side of the pool and he asked him to kick water with his legs. So this is the keyword, kick. After some weeks, his legs became relaxed and he learned how to control them. So finally, after 6 months, the instructor asked Douglas to jump into water and swim. So piece by piece, the instructor built a swimmer, and when he had perfected each piece, he put them together into an integrated whole. What did Douglas do to make sure that he had defeated his fear of water? Now, the instructor was finished, but Douglas wasn't. He first swam across the swimming pool when he was alone in the pool, and this he continued for many days. To make sure that he had conquered his fear of water, Douglas decided to swim across two lakes. Now remember, you might be asked name of the two lakes. He swam across Lake Wentworth, the first lake. In the middle of the lake, he felt a bit of fear but laughed at it and swam on. Finally, he swam across Warm Lake, the second one, and returned. He shouted with joy because he had finally defeated his fear of water. So in exam, you might be asked about name of the two lakes. famous quote by the American president Franklin D. Roosevelt, "The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. All we have to fear is fear itself." Now, what is the message of this chapter? What is the significance of the whole experience of Douglas? The chapter gives us a message that fear is something that we must learn to overcome if we want to succeed in life. Due to the two childhood incidents, California beach incident, California surf incident, and the YMCA incident, Douglas developed a fear of water, but finally he decided to confront his fear. His coming close to death made him understand the value of life. He hired an instructor and conquered his fear. Douglas comes out as a person with fierce determination and strong willpower. He quotes the American president and his close friend, Franklin D. Roosevelt, "All we have to fear is fear itself. Face your fears if you want to succeed." This is the lesson which this chapter gives. Don't write "Dar ke aage jeet hai" in English paper. Instead of this, write "All we have to fear is fear itself." So it simply means you should not be afraid of anything. Okay, students, thank you. Stay healthy and keep learning.